नमस्कार, आई एम राजीव कपूर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, पंजाबी यूनिवर्सिटी नेहरू कैंपस। आई एम ए पार्टिसिपेंट ऑफ फर्स्ट गुरुदक्षता फैकल्टी इंडक्शन प्रोग्राम ऑर्गेनाइज 27 जुलाई 2020 टू 25 अगस्त 2020 बाय यूजीसी ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट सेंटर गुजरात University Ahmedabad. I am going to deliver my presentation on ethical conduct research, publication ethics, issue of the unauthorized collaboration. In next slides, now we will discuss the what is say ethics. Ethic is a principle and guidelines for doing the activity, moral principle that governs the capability and conducting an activity. Ethics refers to the whether a particular practice do a right way and wrong way. What is the purpose? What is the meaning of ethical is a principles, guidelines, which are the use for the conducting a particular research in the field of the social sciences and other. Their principle must be followed by the researchers. Now, the moral responsibility of a researcher will follow the guidelines given by the authority under the he is working, government policies and moral responsibility for the true research. In this slide, we will discuss the ethical conduct of research. Research ethics governs the standard of the conduct scientific research. It is important to follow the ethical principles in order to dignity, rights and research participants. Now, we discuss in detail this concept, ethical conduct. What is ethical conduct? This is the standards, because the standard become the quality and quality provide the good product, good output, good outcome of the research to the welfare of society. A researcher in a university must now follow the guidelines provided by their universities, government authorities. There are many rules and regulations in which the researcher follow to conduct his research to achieve the objective of his research. Now, in this slide, we will discuss the objective of the research ethics. It helps in the bringing out the truth. It helps in promoting the aims and research, widen some value of the research and promote the collaborative work and hold the accountability of a research. Let's now we will discuss in detail of the objective of the research ethics. First one is a help in the bringing out the truth. What is the meaning of this? Bringing out the truth means we follow a researcher, follow the set of the guidelines provided by the university, set of the authorities, and conduct his and her research in a proper way, a systematic way. There is no chance to hide the qualities, hide the hidden, hides the hides the errors, data in the his reserve. Because if a researcher follow the systematic approach of the research, then automatically it provides the truth. It means the quality of the work and quality of the product is produced by this researcher. So next is a avoidance of the error. What is this? Avoidance of the error. If a person follow the steps defined by the research authorities, then there are little chances to do the errors with the guidance of his mentor. Next one is saying, promote the value of the research. What is mean? Actually, a researcher doing the own work with the guidance of the literature, with the guidance of the mentor, and providing the valuable research to the society. Next, promote the collaborative work. What do you mean? What is the collaborative work? In the collaborative work means the teamwork. In the collaborative work, there are the one and two or three, yeah, or the team of the researchers as working on a large project. So there are the principles of the collaborative works that they follow. So collaborative work promotes the quality research and ethical research that produce and serve our nations. Next one is say, hold the accountability of the researcher. Why we follow the research principles? It provides the accountability. Accountability means a researcher thinks, a researcher take the dreams to dream to do the project in the field, in the specified field, and find the problem statement with the using the principles of the research and follow the procedure. So during his research work, the beginning to the end, he can find what is the reality he achieved their objectives in their research. Next, helps in the building public support. So the researcher
provide the research to the welfare of the public. A researcher thinks, if the researcher truly work, truly do their research with the systematic manner, his research will be beneficial to the public and our society. Next one is a help in the getting the participants. The researcher the must help na on participants, because if he her doing the research in a real manner, the number he published their papers in real manners, real true values, true research, the numbers of participants follow the his research, and he can help their research, he can help their them with here with the research and with their new ideas. Next, the avoid the manipulations. The objective of the ethical research to avoid the manipulation. There are a big problem. The some of the researchers the following the fabrication and falsification methods. They take the scripts of the multiple researchers and manipulate the text with the paraphrasing. So if we follow the ethical principle, it helps to protect, it has to avoid the manipulation in their research. It provides the quality of the research in area of the all social sciences, technological, so which produce a quality product, quality research. Next one is a make the research report trustworthy. What is that mean? A PhD student preparing his thesis in the guidance of his mentor, the follow the numbers of the ethical rules, ethical guidelines provided by the under the his university. He put the material on his research report, which are the relevant to the research, which are the elements, which are the activities, which are the experiments are done by the researcher him in the labs, in the survey, and use the statistical methods. So his report should be a glance of the true picture of his research. The research, his report must be clearly defined what he has done, what is the objective of his research, what are the activities done by his researcher. For example, getting the data from the market, firstly framing the problem statement, defining the objectives, collecting the data from survey field, and do the research work, and do the if any statistical research in his work. So the conduct of the ethical research is a a criteria to help us to provide the quality of the research and protect the society from the malfunctioning and fabricated research and duplicated research, and serve the public and society with the valuable research and improvement to our society. In this slide, we will discuss the ethical issue in the publication, duplicate publication, authorship and order, scientific misconduct, including plagiarism, and conflict of interest. Now, we will discuss the duplicate publication. What is a duplicate publication mean? When we are reuse the idea of the other in our work, in the showing the his work, his own work, but this was actually has done by previously. So duplication research is a big problem in the scientific area. So people are doing the copy from one paper, two paper, three paper and four paper and combine them and create one paper. They are trying to fabrication, they are trying to falsification in the papers. So a researcher must avoid these duplication work to provide the quality of the work in his research. Now we will discuss the concept of authorship and order, its order. What do you mean by the authorship and order? This concept is need in the area where the collaborative work is done. One research project have three and four peoples, yeah, a team of the peoples, a team of the researchers are working in a one project. They want to publicate, they want to take the credit of his work, their work. So there must be a coordinativity, there must be a integrity of, there must be a the understanding of these people to take the order according to the work and sincerity. For example, a PhD researcher always give his first name in paper, and second name is his guide, and third name is his co-guide. So first author definitely define the actual work has done, and the second author give the information that which he is assisting to the this job. In the some cases there is two authors, they both are doing the equal job in the research, so the mutual understanding are required to giving the order, the authorship of the papers in mutual consents. Now we will discuss the scientific misconduct in the research. There are the two types of the scientific misconducts commonly considered. One is a fabrication, second is a falsification. what is the meaning of the fabrication, making up data or results, recording and reporting them? Next is a fabrication. Fabrication is a manipulating research material or omitting the data results of the records is not accurately in the research record. The first one is a making up data. That means we are the paraphrasing of your data in on work. We are not giving the credit to the main author of the work. So we taking the data, taking the material, Latin word, this means kidnap. Definition according to the Merriam-Webster dictionary, to steal and pass off the idea and words of another, as someone one, someone on, use author's productions without the crediting the source, to commit the literary theft, present as new or original idea, product derived from the existing source. That means we are using the another person idea without giving the citation to the original research. So ethic, plagiarism is not a crime, but it is a ethical misconduct. It would be considered as a major in a research area. UGC of India University grant of. Now we will discuss the issue. What is a conflict of the interest? A set of conditions in which the professional judgment concerning interest, such as validity of a research study, tends to be unduly included in a secondary interest, such as a financial gain, or may give that the impression. In this slide, we will discuss unauthorized collaboration issue. Unauthorized collaboration with other students without knowledge or consent of the instructor. Instructor's ability to accurately evaluate the individual learning in the serious academic offense. There are the two types of the unauthorized collaboration issues. One is a unintentionally, second is a intentionally collaborative issues. Unauthorized collaboration intentionally submitting the work prepared collaboratively with the another person, the people, without knowing that this would be inappropriate. Second is a unauthorized collaboration. Deliberately submitting the work prepared collaborative with the someone else without the explicit premium from instructor. So in the both cases, the first case is that a person doing the work unintentionally. He doesn't know what he is doing. In the second case, a person is knowing what is doing. He changing the contents in paraphrasing mode. In our word, they copying the contents of the other author and change the lines, change the lines and change the data but the idea is remain same. Thanks.
I am Rajiv Kapoor. Thanks to UGC Human Resource Development Center, Gujarat University, Ahmedabad, for providing me an opportunity to join the first online Guru Dakshata Faculty Induction Program. Thanks.